today we are going to cover a few aspects. So the very first thing which we are going to cover, that what do we mean by natural hazards or disasters? So let us begin with what a disaster and how these natural hazards have been termed as disasters. So from that angle, we have to work out and we have to find out how these natural hazards or natural disasters are maybe a long time features. It's not a new feature. For the long time, the people have been facing various kinds of natural hazards like earthquake, like flood, landslides. Then there are certain accidents which is happening inside the sea. So all such things, even the volcanic eruption, all such things are the natural kind of a disaster. So first of all, let us understand what do we mean by disaster and what is the definition of disaster. The word disaster is derived from a French word. Ek Francisi word se isko derived kiya jata hai, that is called disaster. There is a French word called disaster, disaster. And it was first used in 16th century, which has a meaning of the bad or evil. Bad and evil, and the star mean bad luck in the spiritual terms. So the French people, they used to say, if there is a bad luck or the bad evil, they used to call it disaster. In their word, it was D-I-S-A-S-T-R-A. So all the French people, they pronunciate D as the, so disaster. So disaster is the word which indicates about the disaster. Later on, it was termed as disaster. In Hindi, we have a word like apada, vipatti, mahakal, pralay, mahapralay. All such kinds of Sanskrit and Hindi words have been used in our text, and such situations have been described in our epic granthas. So such granthas and such stories, they tell about various kind of situations which has occurred time and again. So basic, what is the definition of disaster? Disaster is a serious disruption of the functioning of the society, causing widespread human, material or environmental losses which exceed the ability of affecting society to cope with its own resources. Means if any accident is taking place or any natural hazard takes place and which is beyond control of the local administration, so that is the common definition of the disaster, because the local administration is unable to cope up with that kind of a problem, and then it will be termed as a disaster. Suppose the accident took place at some place, rail accident. If it is beyond the control of the local administration and they want support from outside agencies, then it will be called as a disaster. Otherwise, if it is managed locally, then that disaster will be known as the accident or the natural way. But at present, we are discussing only the natural disasters or the natural hazards. So we will be talking in that term only. What is the coping mechanism? Coping mechanism, rich versus poor. As you know, all the developed nations, they have a better facilities, all better infrastructure, and accordingly they are developing themselves, and they can cope up within minutes or within hours. As you remember what happened when this 9/11 tragedy took place in America. If it could have been happened in some other developing nation, they could not have managed in that way. But to the America, they had all agencies and all system, and in spite of all such big disaster, they saved a large number of people. So the coping mechanism of the rich people is better than the poor people. So the poor countries, they have the weak coping mechanism, whereas the rich countries, they have the good coping mechanisms. So till 1970s, the disasters used to be the state subject, and hardly any international forum helping the country. So it all happened on the local coping capabilities. Till 1970s, it was a state subject, and it was hardly taken care by the International Forum. But gradually, under the banner of United Nations, the disaster management policy was adopted by the United Nations, and now there is an agency and which is helping that several countries whenever there is a kind of a disaster or natural hazards. So what is the definition given by United Nations? So as you know, after 70s, the United Nations started working in this direction, and they have given a definition in 1984. This definition says it is an event concentrated in time and space. It is an event concentrated in time and space in which the community undergoes severe damage, such losses to its members and the physical appurtenances that the social structure is disrupted and the fulfillment of all or some of the essential functions of the society is prevented. So whenever such disaster took place or the society is affected at large, so we have losses of human property and natural resources. All the losses are there. So it is prevented. So all the functions get disrupted, like the communication system get disrupted, like that even the transportation system is affected. So that kind of disruption takes place. Natural disasters are unpredictable. It is very obvious, natural disasters, usually they are unpredictable. Disasters are their nature, by their nature are relative, contingent, and often indeterminate. Many of such natural hazards are indeterminate. We are unable to estimate it or predict it. The disasters usually involve high magnitude, low probability events. So it has a low probability events means we can, as per probability, we cannot decide when it will happen. So cause unpredicted and unexpected harm and are worthy of public attention. So whenever it is caused, so it creates a lot of havoc among the people and cause unpredicted and unexpected harm, and are worthy of the public attention. What happened in Kerala, it is all known to us that in the recent past, in this monsoon, the Kerala has been affected a lot, and with under the devastating flood in the month of July, the whole Kerala was affected, month July, August. So there are two types of natural disasters or natural hazards. They are defined or they are categorized in the two category. So as per the speed, they can be divided into the two category. First is called sudden onset disaster or the rapid onset disasters. So they come all of a sudden. So the speed is very high, like earthquakes, you know, within a second it happens and it creates a lot of problem. Then tsunamis is also a part of earthquake, which is happening into the deep sea, and further all the waves are generated, and through that waves the flood may take place in the coastal region. Then the floods, tropical storms, volcanic eruptions, landslides, avalanches, snowfall, and forest fire. So all such activities are very, very rapid. They are sudden onset disasters. So they come within a second. Although floods may be predicted because before that, a lot of precipitation takes place, and after that, the flood comes. And flood may be predicted maybe few days back, but sometime what happens? Like what happened in the Kedar Ghati case? In Kedar Ghati, in 10 or 15 hours, we had a lot of rain. Kedar Ghati, 315 millimeter of rainfall within 10 to 15 hours or maybe 24 hours. So that was unprecedented. 315 millimeter of rainfall within 24 hours. That was the situation in Kedar Ghati case. Similarly, when there was no way at Chennai in 2015, then the flood took its shape, and due to the blockade of the natural drainage in the Chennai city, all the areas were submerged due to the heavy flood after the rain. So the rain is the indicator, but when it is very heavy precipitation, high precipitation, then the floods may not be predicted, and it it takes the dangerous shape. Tropical storms, it can be predicted these days because we are getting the pictures from the satellites and we have the early warning system also. But the volcanic eruptions cannot be predicted. Landslides, what we have, we were talking from a friend from Himachal Pradesh, from the Rodu. He was telling that on 25th of September, there was a huge landslide and one of the main road, which is going from Simla to Rodu, it was blocked. And still it is blocked. So that kind of landslides, it has been accelerated due to the use of heavy machines like JCV. We are using the JCV machine to cut the rocks and to make the way. And during the cutting, it has a huge vibration and the whole rock is damaged. So after during the rain, there is a lot of chance that landslide will take place. So I will give you the case in point, like from Chandigarh to Simla, the government is constructing the 4-lane, but at many places, the roads are blocked due to the landslides and even slides of some rocks. So one side we are trying to develop ourselves, but we are not taking care of the nature. And same thing is happening with the Border Road Organization. This is a major challenge. We have to develop ourselves, but we have to take care of the nature. If all the deep-rooted plants and the trees are going to be removed from that particular patch of rocks or the hilly zone, then what will happen? All the soil will be damaged, and there is a chance due to the loose rocks or the loose soil structure, there will be soil erosion or landslides. So we have to think about it. And in the month of January, every year you might have seen the newspaper or even might have gone through the news that due to avalanche, a large number of soldiers die in the upper reaches of the Himalayas, particularly in the Karakoram zone of Jammu and Kashmir, where there is a lot of snowfall and many of them, our soldiers, get trapped due to the avalanches. And to looking into that condition, here at Chandigarh, there is a avalanche Indian Institute of Avalanche Studies have been created under the DRDO. They are trying to map all the avalanches. They are studying the map or mapping the snowfall in the Jammu Kashmir Valley or the upper Himalayan region. And they try to pass the information to the soldiers or our people there. But in spite of such kind of a communication system with the satellite, sometime what happens, all of a sudden there is a snowfall and during the avalanche, large number of the people get trapped. Then the forest fire is also a very common feature. That in the recent past, the last 2 years, there was a lot of forest fire, particularly in Uttarakhand, even in Himachal Pradesh. And that may happen sometime naturally and sometime it is man-made. The second category of disasters are under the slow onset disasters. That may be the drought or famine. Then the land degradation taking place due to the bad agricultural practices or even the all areas is being converted. Even agriculture land is being converted into the construction land. And so land degradation is taking place. Then the climate change, it is a gradual process. So there are the two things. Climate and weather. So as a common people, we use both the words simultaneously. But the climate is the long-term phenomena and the weather is a short-term phenomena. Weather may change in 10, 15 days or last 1 week or 2 days. So the weather is a short-term phenomena. Climate change is a long-term phenomena. Yesterday in the morning, I told you that how the climatologist and geologist, they think about that climate change is taking place over the millions of years of age. And I also described that how ice age and the hot age has been the recurrent feature in that geological time scale. Again and again, there was a hot cycle, then was a cold cycle. So that particular graph, if you remember, so from that way, the climate change is a very, very long-term phenomenon. It does not happen in 1 or 2 days. So we should use the weather term or mausam in Hindi. So weather is the correct term for the day-to-day phenomena. What is the weather in Chennai? It may be hot, 27 degree temperature or something like that. And similar in Kanpur, that the temperature may be about 35 in during the day, and this, in during the night it may be 15 degree because the winter has started. So that is a weather. That is a weather we talk about. Then the desertification in others, or slow onset disasters, and deforestation and pest infestations. Sometimes happens that pest may come from the nearby countries, or it affect a large patch of our wheat cultivation. It used to happen earlier that some of the pests and insects, they used to come from the Pakistan side, and they used to affect our areas, and our crops used to be damaged in Punjab. So the pest infestation is also the slow onset disaster. Sometimes it may become panic also, may be rapid also, because such insects may grow in large number, or they may migrate from one area to another area after finishing the crops from one area. So that may be slow, but sometime it may get a rapid or ugly shape. Now let us categorize the all activities, all the natural hazards, as per the geophysical phenomena. Because all the natural hazards, mostly they come under the geophysical hazards. So all as per the geological, geohydrological phenomena, they have been categorized in six categories. The first category is the geophysical hazard. Under that category, avalanche, earthquake, lahar is a kind of a volcanic eruption, then landslides, mud flows, sinkholes. You might have seen that in some of the places in America, what happens, the whole house may sink during the night. You are sleeping in your own home, but next day the whole house got sink inside the earth. So there are certain sinkholes in the earth where the things are going down, means it may fall into that sinkhole. So there such sinkholes may be there. Then the volcanic eruption. So volcanic eruption is another hazard. So let us see what are the such six categories. Category number two is called as hydrological hazards. Category number two is the hydrological hazards. Under that, flood, limnic eruption, whirlpool. You might have seen in some of the film like Milan, which was a film where both the actor and actress, they get die in the tragedy when the storm comes, or the in the whirlpool. The maelstrom, then siege and tsunami, all such are known as hydrological hazards. So they are the second category of hydrological hazards. Then the climatic and atmospheric hazards is the point number three. Under this, we have the blizzard, drought, hailstorm, which is very common in all the parts of the country, particularly in the north. Then the heat wave, cyclonic storms, then the ice age. What we have been talking about, the ice age, this has been categorized under the climatic and atmospheric hazards. So all the geologists, they still think there may be chance after some time the ice age or the ice storm may come. Then tornado. So tornado may be another thing. So recent some of the news said that the mystery of the Bermuda Triangle has been solved. So what is that mystery, and what kind of a attraction is there, how it pulls all the ship and all the even aircrafts which are passing through that Bermuda Triangle near America. So all such will be under the category of climatic and atmospheric hazards. There are certain zones, certain areas and certain pockets where such activities, subnatural phenomena happens. And tornado, you know, the tornado can entrap even the big vehicles, and the vehicles may be flown up to maybe 1 kilometer high. So such kind of tornado has been seen in America. Then the category 4 is called wildfire hazard. Wildfire hazard may occur in the forest, but many of such fire these days are the man-made. But the wildfire is also possible during the summer period when two of the branches of the dry tree or even bamboo, due to the wind, wind or any kind of friction, there may be the fire and it will spread throughout the jungle or throughout the forest. Then the biospherical hazards like epidemic and famine. Biospherical hazards, it is due to the bacteria, like several bacteria is there. So epidemic, in 2005 there was a plague in Surat and extreme kind of diarrhea takes the shape of epidemic because with the water and with the air, the bacteria flow and it goes from one person to another and the epidemic is created. Particularly after the flood, there is a chance of epidemic because number of animals, they die, they start decomposing, and during that period number of bacteria may develop and even all drinking water is contaminated. So there is a chance of epidemic. Famine is a long-term situation where the continuous low precipitation will lead to the famine. Then extraterritorial hazard, that is the impact event, solar flare, etc., are called extraterrestrial hazard. Let us see some of the important natural hazards and we should find out that what is happening in that particular hazard. Avalanche, I talked about. An avalanche is a geophysical hazard, a slide of the large snow or the rock mass down a mountainside caused when a buildup of the snow is released down a slope. It is one of the major dangers faced in the mountains in the winter. So I gave you an example of the upper reaches of the Himalayas. During the avalanche, a large number of soldiers are victimized due to such accident due to the avalanche, sudden avalanche. So a big piece of land, big piece of rock along with the snow, they passes down and it may engulf the nearby town or the buildings which are coming in between or the people who are coming in between, and they are buried. Then earthquake is the common natural hazard. An earthquake is a phenomena that results from the sudden release of the stored energy. So tomorrow there is a whole session on the earthquake and earthquake resistant building. So we'll cover all such aspects. So an earth's surface, earthquakes may manifest themselves by shaking or displacement of the ground and sometimes tsunamis. 90% of all earthquakes and 81% of the largest occur around the 40,000 kilometer long, which roughly bounds the Pacific plate. You know, the Pacific Ocean has a lot of hazard. There is an area that is called Ring of Fire. In the Pacific Island, there is an area called Ring of Fire, which has an area about 40,000 square kilometer, 40,000 square kilometer or something like that. So 81% of such earthquakes occur in the Pacific plates. Many earthquakes happen each day, few of which are noticed because they are the large enough to be noticed by the human being. So 10,000 of earthquake take place every day, but some are noticed which are of a higher scale. Then lahar, a terminology came in between. Lahar is a type of natural disaster closely related to volcanic eruption, and it involves large amount of material including mud, rock and ash sliding down the side of the volcano at the rapid pace. These flows can destroy the entire towns in seconds and kill thousands of people. So that kind of a situation, just like a volcanic eruption. So this is the point. Then the landslide, A landslide is a disaster closely related to an avalanche, but instead of occurring with the snow, it occurs involves the actual elements of the ground, including rocks, trees, parts of houses, and anything else which may happen to be swept up. One of my students from Assam, he was working on a problem where a big hillocks came down during a landslide in Assam, and there were one river which was passing through, it was divided into the three tributaries, but this main or the mouth was blocked. Mouth was blocked due to the landslides. Then what happened? All the water which was coming and which was divided into the three, now it was diverted into only one river. Earlier it was passing through the three tributaries. So the two rivers or the two tributaries, they got dried. They were blocked, completely blocked. So the occupation of the people in the two sides of the tributaries, it was largely affected. Agriculture was affected, fishing was affected. And with this impact, what happened? In the third side, which was the main tributary, the whole water was flowing through that tributary and it created flood downside. So in the Barpeta district of Assam, this event happened in 2005, and that mouth of the main river was blocked and the two tributaries were dried. So can you imagine such kind of a natural phenomena when such things may affect the large number of the people? So landslides can be caused by the earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, general instability in the surrounding, the mudslides and the mud flows are the special case of the landslides, in which the rainfall causes loose soil and steep terrain to collapse in the landslide downward. Then recently near to Mumbai or even in Maharashtra, some of the areas in the Konkan region, there is a lot of a chance of a mud flow. All of a sudden mud flow. So landslide, it still may be managed, but mud flow, all of a sudden, it creates another kind of a problem, and it becomes very difficult to remove the debris from the mud. And it had happened in some parts of the country. Then the sinkhole, as I give you some example, the sinkhole is a localized depression in the surface topography, usually caused by the collapse of subterranean structure, such as cave. So there is a cave kind of situation inside the earth, and it engulfs all the whatever the structure may be there up, may be erected above that cave. So although rare large sinkholes that develop suddenly in the populated areas can lead to the collapse of the buildings and structures. You might have seen in the some of the road, in spite of repeated repair and maintenance, that particular patch, still there is a hole, because inside that earth or that system, there is some kind of vacuum, and whatever the material is filled temporarily, it goes down. So there are some weak structure down, and it is moving down and down, and that kind of a sinkhole is be there. Then volcanic eruption. Earlier, there used to happen the large volcanic eruption. All the small plateau which has been created in Chota Nagpur, in Vindhyachal, or even in down south in the Deccan Plateau, all such plateau has been developed after the volcanic eruption. Some of them have got stabilized, so there is no disturbance. But you may find some such islands or such kind of a places where volcanic eruption is very, very common. Where the volcanic eruption is very, very common, but it is a natural phenomenon. Still, some of the islands in Andaman and Nicobar, they have some volcanic activities, and that is going on continuous. So there are some active volcanoes in Andaman, but other places we do not find any active volcano in India. So they range from the daily small eruptions which occur to places like Kilauea in Hawaii, or extremely infrequent super volcano eruptions where the volcano expels at least 1,000 cubic kilometers of the places like Lake Taupo, where the 26,500 years ago, that lake was developed due to the volcanic eruption. So this Lake Taupo is the biggest lake in the world. I will show you the picture just now, which has the potential to become the super volcano in the near geological future. It was a super volcano, which was termed as this Lake Taupo is the New Zealand, and its perimeter is about 193 kilometers from, you can see, from Chandigarh to Delhi. The deepest point of this lake is 186 meters and surface area of 616 square kilometers. So you can imagine how big this lake was created due to the volcanic eruptions. So these are natural phenomena. Many a times it will result into the betterment of the future of the human life, because we need some lakes also, and we need water to survive. So such lakes are created by the volcanic activities. Then the flood is another common problem, particularly in the eastern part of the India, Assam, Bihar, some parts of Tamil Nadu, some parts of Maharashtra, some parts of Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh. But in the recent past, in the last 4 or 5 years, we even see the floods in Gujarat and Rajasthan, where used to be a very low rainfall. So what are the reasons? That reasons are the climatic change or whatever we call. And even we find a huge rain in Barmer, Jaisalmer, where the usual rain per year used to be 200 to 300 millimeter, and sometime it even less than that. Then drought. A drought is an abnormally dry period when there is a lot, there is not enough rainfall or the water to support the agriculture, even the urban and environmental water needs. So that crisis is taking place even in all highly rainfall areas like Cherrapunji, like Darjeeling, like Shimla. They used to receive a high amount of rainfall, maybe 1500 millimeter per annum, but it's not enough. During the summer period, they face the problem of drought. The water is not available during the summer. So the drought situation is faced by our country more frequently. So last year there was a drought, and after that heavy rainfall. So these are unpredicted things are happening in the country. More or less about 250 districts of our country, they are affected by droughts. The cyclone storm is another case. Hurricane or the tropical cyclone and typhoon are the different names of the same phenomena. So they are named differently in the different places. It is named as typhoon in Japan and even in Singapore, and other places it is called hurricane in Europe. The cyclone storm system that forms over the oceans, it is caused by the evaporated water that comes off of the ocean and becomes a storm. So you know that all of a sudden a huge amount of water get evaporated after the heat, and that vacuum is created. In order to fulfill that vacuum, the cold water, a cold air from other places or from the land side, they rush to that place, and this way the hurricane may be generated. So this is a common natural phenomena. It is also known as the Coriolis effect, causes that storm to spin, and the hurricane is declared when it is spinning. Mass of the storms attains the wind speed greater than 74 miles per hour. So if there is more speed, then it is named as hurricane. If it is below 74 miles per hour, then it will not be termed as the hurricanes. So 119 kilometers per hour or 74 miles per hour, that kind of a situation will be termed as hurricane. Hurricane is used these phenomena in Atlantic and Eastern Pacific Oceans. Tropical cyclone in Indian Ocean, it is named as typhoon in the Western Pacific. Tropical cyclone in our area, like in Bay of Bengal, and typhoon in the Western Pacific near to Japan or Singapore. My dear friends, there are other hurricanes, and they are of a devastating nature. So as per the speed, they have been categorized in 5. The 5th category is the most devastating category. few months back, there was a devastating such kind of a hurricane in America, and there is a particular site from it is moving from the Caribbean islands or the West Indies, near to West Indies, Jamaica areas, to the South America. So even the North America is coming in between. So that is a particular patch or the particular pockets where this hurricane takes place after alternate years. So the category number one has a speed of 119 to 153 kilometers per hour. Category number two, which is more higher, 154 kilometers to 177 kilometers per hour. Category number three, 178 kilometers to 208 kilometers per hour. Category number four, 209 kilometers to 251 kilometers per hour. And the most devastating one is more than 252 kilometers per hour. In year 2005, the hurricane was named as Katrina. It was devastating, and it happened from 23rd to 31st August in 2005, and the initial speed was 200 kilometers per hour. And when it reaches to the northern part of the South America, then its speed went down. But in between, whichever the places or whichever the country fall, it was devastated, and havoc was created. All the buildings and the roofs were rooted out, all the trees were rooted out, and large number of the people killed. So wildfire, then it's the next terminology. It is well known to all of you, so I don't want to elaborate further. So wildfire, it may take place, and it is also a natural hazard which has a large speed once it get involved. Then we come to the biospherical hazard. An epidemic is an outbreak of the contractible disease that spreads at a rapid rate through a human population. So it will be moving from one person to another person. When the bacteria or the large amount of contamination takes place, then it moves very fast, and pandemic and epidemic whose spread is global. Many times it may global. Some of the virus coming from one country to another country. Recently, the Ebola virus in the South America or South Africa, Ebola virus. Similarly, in Kerala, there was another virus. So there have been the many epidemics throughout the history, and it has been named as Black Deaths. Cholera and anthrax and the plague were estimated, they have killed around 4 lakh of the people in China. 4 lakh Chinese people were killed due to the cholera or anthrax between a different period, maybe 1300 or 1400. So Black Death or the Black Plague was one of the deadliest pandemics in the human history, widely thought to have been caused by the bacterium called Yersinia pestis, that is plague, Yersinia pestis, but the recently attributed by some of the other diseases. What happened in 1340s in Europe, the total number of the deaths worldwide is estimated about 75 million people died during that period, and 25 to 50 million of which occurred in Europe. So can you imagine, once upon a time during 1300 and 1400, even European countries suffered a lot due to such kind of a pandemic or epidemic. So Black Death is estimated to have killed 30% of the 30 to 60% of the European population between 1300 to 1400. It may be reduced the world population from an estimated 450 million to between 350 to 375 million in 1400. So 1300 to 1400, it was very, very devastating period, difficult period for the Europeans, where such epidemic came frequently. So my dear friends, this session I am going to end here with a slogan, with a saying, that natural hazards are inevitable, but nature preserves the life. You might have seen this polar bears as a symbol, and if some global warming takes place and gradually all the glaciers melt, then they will lose the habitat, they will lose their home, and gradually the number of polar bear will go down. You might have heard about a polar bear that has been named as Yeti. That is a kind of a mystery, and it has been studied by some of the scientists, and they say that the huge size of bear, they have been called as Yeti, and they were found in upper Himalayas. So time and again that story comes. But the most important thing, if we are going at the same rate, if our development process is not checked, then we are going to be affected, and then the natural hazards may take place.